yours truly, Pablo, the merchant of happiness, with my super DJ Kanje on the ones and twos, spinning the wheels, come on, yeah! Feeling aire, siba ulira, hey! Ha ha! Wow, it's Pablo and Kids only here on NBS TV. And yes, if you're watching the show for the very first time, you are our special guest. This show is brought to you by Sam's Foods, the makers of the finest snacks ever in UG. Go to the nearest supermarket, make sure you ask for Sam's. They have Gonja, and their latest is called Toke. My favorite is the barbecue flavor. And you can also purchase them online. That is www.sams.ug. And Sam's is S-U-M-Z or S-U-M-Z, depending on which school you went to. Well, on the show today, we're excited to bring you one of the most intriguing forms of swimming. Now, swimming is one of the best exercises because the whole body participates, you know? The hands, the legs, the hair also comes out wet. However, during the lockdown, because people are not swimming, they came up with a new form of swimming, which was called swimming without water. Now, I thought it was a joke, until there was a competition of which we are excited to have some of the finest participants. One of them is Linda Kamahoro. Linda is something else and her entire fraternity when it comes to swimming. Watch this video.
Linda Tendo Kamahoro. She writes poems, heads a swimming club, cooks, knits, dances and models. 12-year-old Linda Tendo Kamahoro is the outgoing captain of a swimming club, the Wales Swimming Academy. She started swimming when she was only 3 years old. Her swimming club participated in the Swimming Without Water Challenge, a rare kind of swimming that was started during the COVID-19 lockdown that found everyone indoors. Because they couldn't swim in the pool, the Swimming Without Water Challenge was birthed. It has turned out to be much more fun today than they initially expected. Linda is also a fine poet. She has marvelous rhythm and impeccable rhyme. Her imagination is beyond her years. She is also a born leader. Linda was elected head girl of SOS Primary School. She has a genuine passion for her work, follows her dreams, and inspires the same purpose in others. Let's meet Linda Tendo Kamahoro, the multi-talented swimmer.
Welcome to Linda Kamahoro from Wales Swimming Academy. You're very welcome, Linda.
Thank you.
What's this on your t-shirt?
I'm that good.
Are you that good?
Yes.
Oh, that's so cool. Have a seat, Linda. Tell me about swimming. What's this swimming about where you swim without water?
It's when you swim without water. Yeah. During the lockdown,
yeah,
we're not allowed to go to the swimming pools.
Mm.
And some of us didn't have money to go to the swimming pools.
Yes.
So you just had to swim without water to save money and to have fun. It was also fun,
yeah,
because we won, and as an academy, we felt so happy after winning the Swimming Without Water Challenge.
Swimming Without Water Challenge?
Yes.
How many people were involved in this competition?
Very many people.
There are very many.
And they were competing against very good academies.
Wow.
But our surprise, God helped us and we won.
And you won the competition.
Yes.
Well, let's go back to the basic. Let's talk about just swimming. What is swimming all about? What are some of the styles in swimming?
There are mainly four styles in swimming. There is breaststroke.
Uh-huh.
There's backstroke. When I was at school, my friend asked me how many strokes are there in swimming.
Mm.
I told her that there are four strokes. She asked me give the examples. I gave breaststroke, then I said, then I went to backstroke. Then she was like, is there a stroke called backstroke? I said yes, and said, how can you swim backstroke? It's just when you swim on your back. Breaststroke, when I first heard of breaststroke, I thought it was using your breasts to swim.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Until my coach taught me how to swim breaststroke with freestyle and Butterfly.
And butterfly.
Yes.
So now, assume you're talking to a person who has no idea, who only swims in a basin. What is, you've said, what is the breaststroke, for example?
I would like one of my swimmers to demonstrate how to swim breaststroke.
Hey, you even have demonstrators?
Yes.
Okay, where? Who's the demonstrator? Whom are you going to invite to demonstrate for us?
Isaiah.
Isaiah?
Yes.
Isaiah, come and show us what is the breaststroke. Uh-huh. Let's welcome Isaiah. Uh-huh. So, which is the breaststroke? Like that? Yeah. Uh-huh, that's the breast stroke. Looks like a head stroke. Uh-huh. And then which was the other stroke?
Back stroke.
Which is the back stroke?
I would like also one of my swimmers to demonstrate how to swim back stroke.
Okay. You can take your seat, let another demonstrator come so that we can know who demonstrated which one. Uh-huh, who's the next?
Melvin.
Melvin. Yeah, let's welcome Melvin. Melvin's going to ask the backstroke.
In backstroke, it's basically like doing freestyle, but you're on your back. So you keep your hand, after you push off from the wall, you keep one hand straight tight on your head, and then you begin doing freestyle kicks, which is where you point your toes and kick very quickly. While you alternate your hands, once one has touched, reached
the
your...
mic has gone to swim.
Okay, once one arm has reached your thigh, the other arm must be tight on your head, and you keep alternating like that while lifting your shoulders out of
like
the water.
This.
So
looks like a break dance.
Could you hold this? Then I show you.
Uh huh.
So, you, like one hand is here.
Uh huh.
You keep switching while you're lifting your shoulders upwards like this out of the water. So the faster you move your arms, the faster you go.
That's the backstroke.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. Which is your favorite?
I'll have to say I have two. Mm. Freestyle and breaststroke.
Freestyle and breaststroke.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Which other different strokes are there?
There's backstroke and
butterfly.
Butterfly, yeah.
Butterfly.
Yeah.
Do you know the dive stroke? The dive stroke.
What's
that? Where people jump like this, woohoo! And they fall inside. Is that the dive stroke?
That's not a stroke.
What is it? It's not a stroke?
Yes.
What is it?
That's basically called diving.
It's called diving. Oh, I thought it was a stroke.
Yeah.
The other stroke is a disease. I don't like it.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay, thank you so much. Say, what's your name again?
Melvin James Thompson.
Melvin James Thompson.
Yeah.
Wow, that's so cool, man. And how old are you?
I'm 12.
You're 12 years old.
Yeah.
That's very good, man. You're just 1 year older than me.
Yeah.
Yes. So let's clap for him. Aha. By the time this show ends, I'll have known how to swim. So tell me, Linda, which is your favorite stroke?
Butterfly.
Butterfly. Why do you like butterflies?
It's one of the strongest strokes. It's like swimming like a butterfly, and a butterfly is pretty. So I like swimming like a butterfly. And though I'm not that fast in butterfly because I've not got enough training, but when I get enough training, I'll be like my favorite icon, Michael Phelps, who's among the best butterflyers.
Michael Phelps, the American?
Yes.
Yeah, I know him.
Yes.
When he's swimming, he wears glasses.
Goggles.
See that one?
Yes.
They're called goggles.
Yes.
I thought they were like shades so that you can see properly in the water.
Yes.
Hey, so they're called goggles.
Yes.
Hey, swimming goggles.
Yes.
Okay. So Michael Phelps is your favorite.
Yes.
Let's talk about, let's talk about Wells Swimming Academy. What's it all about?
Thank you, Pablo. It's about a swimming academy. Mm. It's all about swimming, training, swimming for fun, swimming for competition, swimming to save lives. It's like a school.
So how did you
swimming.
Come up with that? How did you decide to engage in the swimming without water? When they told you, how did you feel?
Before they even brought that competition up, we were already doing it because our children were forgetting the skills at home. The pools were closed, we were indoors. So we had already come up with that we used to swim in our homes, in our compounds, in our houses. So we came up with that with our coaches. They trained us online because we couldn't even meet. So we did it
now
at home.
Now that the lockdown ended, will you continue swimming without water?
Yes, we still do. If you don't have money to take your kid to the pool and the child is interested in swimming, these are competitors, competing swimmers. They have to participate in galas.
Hey.
Yes, so we keep training at home. So when it comes to water, it's just a walkover.
Let's talk about Linda. What is she passionate about?
Linda is passionate about cooking. She loves cooking, but she's one child who is active in everything. Anything that comes up, she will say, "Mommy, let me try. Let me take part." I said, "But you are not a footballer. I can't try.
And when to play football.
So you just need to just push her a little bit, and she will push herself, find her way on top.
What do you think about wrestling?
It's fun.
It's fun.
But it's dangerous.
It's dangerous.
Yes.
So what is the plan?
Don't try it at home.
Don't try it at home.
Yes.
That's a very good one. Yeah?
Yes.
That's a very good one. So you also love football. Who's your favorite footballer?
I don't love football.
You don't love football?
No.
What do you love?
I love knitting, cooking, modeling, swimming. Yeah. Not making pots.
Yeah.
Modeling.
Which one do you like?
Mm-mm.
The one of walking on the catwalk.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Why is it called catwalk?
I don't know.
Even I don't know. Because there are many animals. There's dog walk, it could
because
be
because I think
walk.
A cat models.
A cat
so
models.
That's why it's called a catwalk.
That's why it's called a catwalk.
Yes.
Well, if you're watching this, we shall be having supermodels who tell us why it's called a catwalk. So, what message do you have for kids out there who want to learn how to swim and be swimming champions like you are?
Not only swimming, I would like to send a message to my fellow young people like me there that it's not only one talent that you can have. You can be multi-talented. Reason being, in future, when you want to find a job and, like, let me say swimming fails, you can do cooking. If cooking fails, you can do knitting. So they are very many talents. So you don't need to rely on one talent. You need to be multi-talented. Just be passionate and follow your dreams and put your faith in God.
I totally agree with you because I'm also a good cook. I cook stories.
Yes.
Yeah, so we shall continue.
Yes.
Looking for other things that make life interesting.
Yes.
That's very good. It's been a pleasure having you on the show.
Thank
you. And I look forward to coming to watch you swim. And will you teach me how to swim?
Yes, and next time you invite me, I'll teach you how to knit, teach you how to cook, I'll teach you how to do poetry. Yes, I'm also
I'll teach
likes.
You how to somersault.
Yes.
Roll and diving. Not
yes.
so?
Yes.
Well, don't go away. You're still watching Pablo and Kids. Don't go away. We'll be back after the break.